Hi, my name is David, and in today's video, I want to talk about what is the difference between the new Ghost Sublime Toner and existing sublimation solutions in the market. I mean, if you've been in the transfer business for a while, you're probably really familiar with inkjet-based sublimation systems. I'm not going to name any manufacturers or any brands here, but we know that these systems are widely spread in the market for the personalization of, for example, polyester-coated mugs or polyester-coated fabrics, like, for example, baby bodies or sports fabric, or, of course, coasters and all these other fantastic polyester blanks, sublimation-enabled blanks which are out there. So with Ghost Sublime Toner, we're actually kind of the newbies in the market, and I just want to tell you a little bit about the differences and the advantages of the Sublime Toner. So first of all, as you can see, laser toner cartridges are slightly bigger than inkjet cartridges. These are inkjet cartridges from an inkjet sublimation system, and these are laser toner cartridges for the HP LaserJet M452, which have the Sublime Toner inside. So as you can see, a laser cartridge is slightly bigger. Of course, that also makes a difference, you know, when you take a look at this tiny ink cartridge or this laser cartridge when it comes to print yield, but I'm going to hit that topic later on. Inkjet systems are based on a liquid which is inside the tank. You can hear it if you shake it. There's a liquid inside the tank. This has the advantage that you have a very good color pigmentation, very detailed colors, very rich colors. But of course, liquids can dry out. These inks are usually not vacuum sealed once they are inside the printer. So once opened, air can be attacking the liquid and it can evaporate and it can dry out. This can get even worse if it dries out inside the printer and starts blocking your print head. This will make you have to exchange the print head, which comes at a little more cost. So this is one of the downsides. You can, of course, avoid this by keeping your printer running all the time. So let's say if you're doing a print job every 2 days or every 3 days or at least once a week, this will not happen. But if you only use your sublimation printer occasionally, it's very likely that the print heads can block, and this, of course, will occur in other costs. Laser toner is totally different. I'm taking the black cartridge here for you to see. I'm removing the protective plate because this is not ink-based, it's powder-based. They can shake it as much as I want. There's nothing to hear. So there's a powder, a black toner powder in here, and of course colored toner powders in here. You can also see that. I'm going to hold that to the camera a little bit. So you can see the yellow roller here, just below the green OPC drum, and the black roller here. So that's the black cartridge, that's the yellow one. So as this is already dry powder, there's no need for it to dry out. So this means you can actually store Sublime Toner cartridges for a shelf life of over 3 years. So if you purchase Sublime Toner and you want to just put it in a shelf and, you know, maybe use it at a later time, you're secured. You're getting a 3-year warranty from us, plus it has a shelf life of 3 years. Even if you once opened a toner cartridge and you store it back into the box or into a cupboard in the black bag, the shelf life of it is still the same. And even if it's inside a printer, the shelf life is still the same. So basically, there's no reason to dry out or to fade or whatever for the cartridge. If you want to check out how to best store your cartridges, I've made a video on how to exchange cartridges, and I'm dropping a few lines on storage there as well. But that's how we overcome one of the downsides of the existing technologies. All right, so let's have a little look at print yield comparison, all right? So we wanted to actually print a comparable sheet, you know, like people used to print face designs, graphic designs with lots of color, or artwork with lots of color. So you can't go ahead with a standard 5% or 7% test page. So what we actually chose was a 40% test page, full color, full coverage, and we printed this test page with the Ghost Sublime Toner and with a commonly used inkjet sublimation system. And we just did run the prints as long until the cartridges went empty. Okay, so we just waited until the print started to fade, and then we said that's the print yield. So we have a comparison of this test page printed with Ghost Sublime Toner and with a very popular sublimation inkjet system. And the result is tremendous. You can see that on the picture, which we'll move in here. The high stack of papers that you see is the Ghost White Toner. It actually printed 1,902 pages, and it only took the printer about 10 minutes to do the job, right? And the lower stack you see there, it's 387 pages printed with a sublimation inkjet, and it took the printer 35 minutes almost to quit the job because the ink had to dry and the paper path moves much slower. So when it comes to print yield comparison, I think the Sublime Toner absolutely has the advantage of being not only having a much higher print yield, but also being much quicker, because this will run down your production times. You don't have to wait for prints to be finished, because you can, you know, just print pages at almost the speed of 30 pages per second or 25 pages per second, depending on the design and on the printer that you use. So this is one fantastic advantage of Sublime Toner. All right. Frankly, the pricing of the Sublime Toner is, of course, higher than of the small inkjet cartridges. But if you compare the pricing, you will see that the cost per page are, depending on if you're using like small inkjet tanks or you're using a continuous ink supply, the costs of the Sublime Toner are about 25 to 35% cheaper per page based on this test page than with a comparable inkjet solution. So this is quite stunning. And even more, when you're printing on with inkjets, with ink solutions, you will need to print on a release sheet paper which has a special coating, like a transfer sheet. With Ghost Sublime Toner, you don't need to do that. You just print on standard copy paper. It's a standard 80 gram copy paper, so you're even saving some money there. So the stack of 1,902 sheets of regular copy paper, which only costs around €2, can be compared to a stack of 387 sheets of sublimation paper, which cost around €80. So, you know, whether you're using a really cheap or one of the more expensive type of sublimation papers, you can't beat the cost of regular copy paper, because these are like really down below. So this is one other advantage. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about image quality. Of course, a laser printer has a smaller color space than an inkjet printer. And of course, a laser printer is not that optimized for photographic or fine arts printing as an inkjet printer. Standard laser printers run between 600 and 1200 dpi, while inkjet printers easily run between 2400 and 4800 dpi with interpolation depending on the model. So of course, you're getting much more detailed colors and much more photographic range of color, much more color space with a sublimation-based system. So this really depends on what you're doing, right? So for example, these samples which have been produced using Ghost Sublime Toner, and you can also check other videos where we are actually producing products using Ghost Sublime Toner, or you can visit us on one of the shows or in our showroom to check out the image quality. But I think it's quite great. It's brilliant, it's shiny, the colors are sharp and crisp, and the contrast is just right. If you're into like really fine art printing, maybe the quality of the print, the accuracy of the colors can't match up with an inkjet solution, but this is absolutely your choice. When it comes to all productions of promotional items, like keyrings, phone covers, mugs, baby bodies, coasters, you know, all these things that are only used for a few times, all these things that need to be produced in masses at a cheap price in a quick time frame, Ghost Sublime Toner outbeats this inkjet solutions, because it's quicker, it's cheaper, and it's easier to use. And of course, if you're printing like vector artwork like this, the image quality doesn't matter, it's just simply the same. Even if you're printing photographic designs or other vector artwork or mixed like clip art style artwork like this, the quality is absolutely perfect. So this is where the price point of the sublimation toner actually hits it. And there's one more advantage, which I have already been talking about in a previous video. It comes up in the info pane, so you can click on this to see the video. where I'm actually explaining the differences between Sublime Toner and White Toner. But when you use a Ghost system with Sublime Toner, you can at any time swap back to regular toner cartridges and just start doing your office and paper printing. You wouldn't do that with an expensive dye sublimation inkjet system. And of course, you can use the combination of white and color toners for transfer onto dark textiles, dark fabrics, and so on. So with Ghost Sublime Toner, you get a system that is really versatile, cost-effective, and perfect for small to medium and big runs of sublimation items that can also be used with white toner for dark fabrics. So is there a need to throw away your old sublimation printer? I would say no. If you already have a sublimation printer, you're absolutely fine with it. It's absolutely perfect. If you're thinking about getting a transfer printer to personalize cotton fabrics and other garments with white toner, I would really suggest you to take a look into Ghost White Toner, because you can combine Ghost White Toner with Sublime Toner and only have one system working you for both solutions. All right, I think that's it on comparing Ghost Sublime Toner with standard inkjet sublimation solutions. If you have any further questions on this topic, or if I have missed out on anything, please feel free to leave a comment below so that we can follow this up by either answering the comments or making another FAQ on this. If you liked the video, give us a thumbs up below and make sure that you follow our channel to see future videos and updates on new products and technology. Also, check our other videos in this playlist on how to use Ghost Sublime Toner to make sure that you're using it right and that you get the perfect results you want to have. I say thanks for watching and see you next time.